So I've got this old nozzle that I've drilled out to 1.5mm diameter. I just use it to put on the hot end when I finish machining it, when I finish assembling it, to flush any filament through, just in case there's any debris or metallic swarf or anything inside the hot end that would otherwise clog a smaller nozzle. Wouldn't want to print with it, and it's 1.5mm diameter, that would be sort of crazy. You'd be talking with die swell probably 1.65, 1.7mm layer width. And I did some work back in 2018 with the Diamond 5 colour, just using PLA, and got up to, I think it was 300 millisecond print speed with a 0.5mm nozzle, something like that. Might be interesting to see what this 6 input one would do. Could set the tools to equal mixing ratio, say 17%. For four of them and 16% for the other two, give 100%. But it takes a lot of cooling. 1.5mm nozzle, 1mm layer height, that's a lot of plastic. So it needs to print something pretty big so it's got time to cool. So that would use a lot of filament. I'm running low on PLA. But I've got a lot of old PETG, a load of that, it's about 4 or 5 years old. Probably not much good now, probably absorbed plenty of water, I would have thought. PETG is a lot more viscous, a lot higher viscosity, so a lot less runny than PLA. PETG through a 1.5mm nozzle at a high flow rate, be pretty crazy. I like crazy. Let's do it. So, having loaded all six inputs with this old PETG, I tried to see how quickly I could extrude before the extruder started kicking up. First thing I noticed was that it was popping and spitting as it was warming up, so I think it's probably quite moist. But anyway, it needed using up. So I kept extruding 300mm at a time and increasing the speed until the extruder started to skip and play up. And I got up to about 25ms. And then I sliced a 300mm cube with single wall thickness. And then I had a look at the G-code and I could see that for one of these long 300mm moves, it would extrude about 170 some odd. Mill of filament. So when I divided that by 25ms, I came up with about 7.2 seconds or something. So it seemed like the speed to use would be around 42ms. That would give me 300mm in 7.2 seconds or thereabouts. So then I just designed a simple vase, 280mm at the bottom, 320mm at the top, 300mm tool. Sliced it with one bottom layer at 1mm layer height and one perimeter at 1.65mm layer width, and printed it. Here's what happened.